أعزائي الطلاب، السلام عليكم. اليوم راح نبلش في نيو توبك في المهارات الحاسوب 2 للسي بلس بلس. وي ويل ستارت توكينج اباوت سمثينج كولد اريز. وات وي مين باي الاريز؟ اللي هي المصفوفات. الاريز يو نيد تو نو الاريز بيكوز اتس فيري امبورتنت فور يو تو ستور a lot of data elements and deal with them as a group. It's in the matter of fact, it's part of C++ regarding something called data structure. How can we structure the data? We use arrays, we use different types, stacks, queue, or whatever. So we will take arrays. Arrays is a group of variables, okay? So this is the objectives of our class, is to understand and use الاريز ان ذا بروجرام ذا سي بلس بلس بروجرامينج لانجويج. اوكي، وي شود نوت فورجيت ذا داتا تايبس. وات وي مين باي ا داتا تايب؟ داتا تايب اتس ذا اللي هو الدومين اور التايب اوف اليمنت يو نيد تو يوز ان يور بروجرام. ات كان بي نمريك انتجر، نمريك فلوت، دبل، ات كان بي كاركتر، ات كان بي سترينج. It can be, so these data types is very important because we need to use them as in variables. We use them with arrays too, okay? So structured data type is one data type for a group of variables. So this is what we mean by structured data type. So what we mean by array? Array, in the matter of fact, you can find a lot of definition for the array, but the most important thing is not to memorize the definition, is knows the to know the concept. It's a collection of fixed numbers of components wherein all the components have the same data type. We have one dimensional array and we have two dimensional array, we have three dimensional array. So the array in general, the array is a group of variables. Group of variables, group of memory locations. They have the same name. They have the same type. They are contiguous beside each other in the memory. Okay. We used to define one variable, but if we define a collection of variables, if we define an array, this means a group of variables will occupy adjacent locations in memory. كلهم لهم نفس التايب، the same type، ولهم the same name في C++. Okay, so how to define or declare an array? You have to specify the data type. What data types we took? Integer, we took float, double, char, bool. So you can choose whatever this group of elements, the type you want to use in your program. Of course, the array it should have a name. So you should specify a name, and the rules here applies to the identifier name, not to start with a number, not to contain space. All the variable names applied are here, okay? Here we have two square brackets, and this inside you put an integer number or expression produces a number. An integer, how many locations you want in this array, or how many variables you want in this array, okay? So here, what we call is the size of the array, and it should be integer. You can't put float or double or even variable here. It should be constant, or it should be number or expression. It produces an integer value. Okay, let's take example. How to declare one variable, integer type, num. If you put semicolon here, you declare one memory location called num. But if you put the square bracket here and put 5, then the semicolon, then you will have 5 variables. All of them have the same name, num, and all of them have the same type integer. So here you have 5 variables with the same name, with the same data type. Okay. Okay. So we have, now we have an array num. So how to, how can we recognize each element in the array from the other? كلهم اسمهم num. كيف نعرف انه هذا ايش بيختلف عن الثاني؟ We give them something called the index. فاول واحد دائما ببلش فيه اللي هو الزيرو. This is the first num. Num zero. Num square bracket zero. Num square brackets one. Num break two. Num brackets three. Num four. We don't have num five because if you we start from zero. So one, two, three, four, five. So if you declare an array integer num 5, this means the first element will be num 0 and the last element will be num 4, which is less than the size by 1. We don't have num 5 here. Num 5, you can't use num 5 because we don't have an element called num 5. Something else, this is the size. It should be integer and or constant with integer value. Or it can be expression that produce an integer value, but it can't be a usual variable. It should be constant or number or expression. Okay. Okay. Here the same thing. Here we call it the size 5. Here we call it the index of the subscript. So the first number subscript is 0 or index 0. The second one index second element num 1. The third element num 2, the fourth element num 3, the fifth element num 4. Okay. Okay, like the variables. When you declare a variable and you don't put a value inside it, it will contain rubbish data. So for now, num 0, if you write C out num 0, it will give you rubbish data because we didn't initialize these array elements. Okay. Okay, so this is what we got. If you go to the memory, inside the memory, and after you put the statement int num 5, you will find these 5 locations beside each other in the memory, contiguous, starts with num 0 and ends with num 4, okay? What's inside? We didn't initialize them, so this is rubbish data. Inside rubbish data like variables exactly. So to access an array component, what we mean by accessing array component is using them. You want to print them, see out, you want to multiply them with another number, you want to do anything. This means accessing this array element or component. An array element, you have to specify the array name and which element you want to access, starting from 0 to the size minus 1. So all these the elements of that. So the first element is 0 and the last element is the array name size minus 1. So this is the index of the array or the subscript of the array. 0, 1, 2, 3 until the size minus 1. Okay, the array index always starts with zero. So this is, we talked about. Now if you write this in your C++ program, this is a declaration, like declaration a variable, but we are declaring an array. Int, type of integer, list, I want to name the array list, and how many variables I want, 10. So, what will happen? You will not see what will happen. It will not print you to the screen these things. This is the memory inside. The memory, the C++ compiler or executor will go to the memory and will allocate 10 variables like this. All of them called list. The difference between them is the index. It starts with list 0, the first one, and the last one will be the size minus 1, will be 9. So this is the first one, second one, third one. This is the fourth element, list 3. This is the fifth element, and so, okay? if you want here, okay, we declare them. If you want to print this one, cout list bracket zero, it will print for you rubbish data because it's not initialized yet. Okay, if you want to store values inside the whole array element, it's like variable. You use the assignment operator, you saw equal. So list five will equal 34. So I will go. So list five is the sixth element, saddest, because we start from zero. So list five will be 34. The list will be yes, rubbish. Okay. So this is how we store values inside the array elements. Okay, list three equal 10. This means this three which okay, this list three which element list three is the fourth element, yes? List three is the fourth element because we start from zero. So list three will equal 10. So 10 will be assigned or stored in memory location list three or for variable list three. Each of them is a variable. You can deal with it like a variable. And variable. You can print it, you can multiply it, you can apply calculation or arithmetics on it as you like. List six, element seven will equal 35. So the seventh element with index six, but it's the seventh because we start from zero. List six will equal 35. List five will equal variable. List three. List three is 10. So 10 plus list six. List six is 35. So it will be 45. It will be stored inside variable list five, which is the sixth element. Okay. So the idea here, you can deal with the array elements as variables, okay? So each of this of these elements is a variable and can be used in calculations and can be assigned a value and you can see out it. If you want to print, for example, list three, you write see out list brackets three. It will print 10 as a variable, okay? Okay, the other way of you can declare a variable as follows: constant integer array size equal 10. Integer, of course, here you don't need to use integer all the time. You can, for example, if you need float, you can put float or double or character or whatever type you want. Okay, any type. List is the name of the array, and here array size it's constant with value 10. So it's like integer list 10, okay? If you delete the word constant here, const, put the integer array size equal 10, then integer list array size, it will give you an error. Here you can't put in the size of the array, you can't put here a variable. You only can put a constant like this example, okay? Okay, but as a subscript or index, you can use variable as an index, but you can't use it as a size of the array in declaring the array, okay? So when you declare array, the size must be known. This is why it should be a constant or known or whatever. So integer array size, see out integer the size, cn array size, see out int line, integer list array size. This will, the compiler will give you an error. Why? Because the array size can't be a variable. It can be only constant. And if you want constant here, you should put a value directly here, equal something. So this code will not work. Why? Because you can't declare an array with a variable. You can declare an array with an integer or with a constant or with expression produce integer, okay? Integer value. Okay, how to process one-dimensional array? there is a lot of things. For example, initialize, like variable initialize, we need to initialize the array elements. We have to enter values to the array elements. We have to print or output اللي هم values اللي موجودين في الarray. You need to find the largest or the smallest element في الarray, for example. You need to arrange the array في increasing or for decreasing order. All these are processing in one dimensional array. To use all these, it's easier to use loop. Because if you have 100 elements in the array and you need to give them value, you can't come to array 0 and put value, array 1, array 2. No, you can just use a loop. It will make things easier for you, okay? So we use loops with one dimensional array. We use loop, for usually our loop العادي, okay? So for example, consider the declaration integer list 100. The first question, how many elements we have in this array? 100. What's the first element? List 0. What's the last element? List 99. What's the contents of list 0? See out list 0. Rubbish data because we don't have anything. So to input data or to use the array in any way, so you have to use the for loop. So you start from integer I, for example, for I equals 0, the index 0, the I less than 100, so it will reach 99, I plus plus. Then you will do anything, for example, C out list I. So it will print list 0, then list 1, then list 2, until list 99. Which is the last element in that. So here the idea is most of the time we use اللي هو loop with one dimensional array. We'll nested loop with two dimensional array. Okay. So for example, if you want to enter the grades of 99 students, what you do? Okay, here I will put double grade or double list 100. This means I have 99. This means I have 100 element. So for I equals 0, I less than 100. So I will reach 99 and stop. I will cn list I. So it will cn list 0, I plus plus 1, cn list 1, list 2, 3, 4, 5, until 99. 100, then we'll go out. So the last element in this array is list 99. Okay. So let's see this example. We will have introduction today and we'll continue later. Let's have see this example, double sales 10. So we have here sales 10. So how many sales we have? 10 sales from sales 0 to sales 9. Integer index, double largest sale, sum will average. So for index equals 0, index is a variable. So you here declared an index. You don't need to call it index. You can call it I or whatever. But index, it's the number of the variable among all the variables. The order starting from 0. So for index is equal 0, index less than 10 to 9, because we have here from 0 to 9. Index plus plus, sales index equals 0.0. So all the array elements now, sales 0 will equal 0. Sales 1 will be 1. Sales 2 will be 0. Sales 3 will be 0. So this is the initializing array. All elements are 0, okay? Okay, we can, for example, input from the keyboard the values of the cells. We use the same loop for index equals 0, index less than 10, index plus plus. Here, cn sales index. The first one to be entered is sales 0. Then the index will become 1, sales 1, cn sales 1, cn sales 2, until 9 times. Okay, so this statement, you need to enter 9 numbers. How to print these elements that you entered them in this loop. And instead of CN, you write C out, the same loop from 0 to 9. Here you can write index less than 10 or index less or equal 9. Okay, so the same thing. So the same loop, but here we see out the sales index. So what's the output? The output is the sale is 0. It's what you have entered here. Okay. So this is how we deal with the one-dimensional array using loops. This is introduction, and we continue next class. Yatikum al-afiyah.